Well, hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another episode of Skywind 007. On today's episode, we're going to be looking at this. This is the One for All Universal Remote for Streaming. So this is what you get right here, and it promises to be very simple to use. And in this video, we're going to take a look at it, see if it's any good, and we're also going to learn how to program it. So when you open it up, this is what you get right here. Okay, so I looked at the instructions and it does say to press over here and then push that way. So you press like this and then push that way, and that opens it up. As you can see, this does take 4 AAA batteries. And there you have it. Okay, you're most likely here because you want to know how to set up your TV. So there are 3 ways to set up your TV. There's the simple set programming, there's the set by code programming, and then there's the remote learning programming. So we're going to start with number 1, the simple set programming. To do that, you start off with step 1, find out the brand of your TV. Once you know that, you have to come over here and look it up on the remote. So this is what you get. Let's pretend that your TV is a VCO. For example, right there, that's a VCO. Let me zoom in. So this is the key of interest, the fast forward key. So that's what we have to remember for the VCO TV that we have. And then you come over here, and you're going to, step 2 is going to be press these 2 right here, the power and left button. So let's do that. Press and hold. And you get those 2 flashes. Now you press the VCO button, which was the fast forward. You press and hold, and then you aim it at your TV. As soon as the TV reacts, you let go. And then you get that acknowledgement, those flashing green, that tells you that the TV, the remote has been set. So let's do that again, just for practice. Press these 2 on the left, press and hold them at the same time. Okay, double flash, that means that it's ready. Let's do that VCO again. Press the fast forward, press and hold, and then you aim it at your TV and wait for the TV to react. Once it reacts, let go, and it'll flash twice. That is an acknowledgement that the TV and remote have been paired. So the kind of reaction you're expecting from your TV is to turn on or turn off. Okay, so let's okay, so going back to the remote, as you can see over here, as you can see, they're only offering you just a few brands, mainly because there are no buttons, there are no numbers on this remote. So they offer you Bush, Grundig, I never heard of that, LG, Panasonic, Philips, Samsung, Sony, Sharp, TCL, Thomson, Toshiba, and VCO. But of course, the odds are that you have a TV that is not included in one of these. So if that's the case, then you have to move on to the second type of programming. So that does take us to the setup by code. So that's right here. And by the way, I'm only covering TV at the beginning of this video, and then I'm going to touch about the topic of the other kinds of devices like streaming box and soundbar, audio receiver, and Xbox. So anyway, let's go back to the programming by code, setup by code right here. So it's very similar. You press those two buttons, which are these two on the left. That's going to be step number one. Step number two is going to be typing in a code. So here's where it gets complicated, because there are no numbers on this remote. So to find out the code that goes for your TV, you are going to need this manual. And then you do get this pamphlet right here that has all the codes, as you can see, and I am going to put them up on the video. So in case you've lost this, you can just look it up right here. If not, you can go to the manufacturer and they'll tell you what code your TV goes with. So let's pretend we have an RCA TV. So let's look, here we go, RCA. So it's 21522. So like I said, it does get complicated for this remote because it doesn't have numbers. So you have to use this information right here. Every one of these buttons corresponds to a number. The TV power button is number one. The red power button, that's number two. The left button is number three. The home button is number four. The return button is number five. And that star button, that's number six. If we want to program our RCA TV, the way you're going to do it is the usual. You press and hold those two buttons and then you wait. You press and hold these two buttons and you wait for the signal. And then you're going to have to type in that number, that 21522, according to this chart. So let's press and hold. Okay, so let's do 21522, and then you get that acknowledgement. So now your remote has been programmed. So now it's just a matter of going over there and testing it with the power button and see if it works. But right now it's set up for that particular brand. So let's do that again. Let's pick another number this time. So let's look up a different brand. For example, let's see. So we're on TVs. So let's see Epson. So that's 41321. 41321. So if you look at the chart right here, to type 41321, you're gonna have to press the following buttons. Here's 4, 1, 3, 2, 1. So let's do that. So you come over here and you press and hold those two buttons. And there's our acknowledgement. So now type 41321. And then those two green flashes, that tells you that the remote has been programmed. And now it's just a matter of going to the TV and testing it. So that's how you do that. Let's review the third type of programming. So that's when you actually have the remote. So I'm sure most people are here because you've lost the original remote for the TV and you no longer have that. So this is not going to apply to you. This only applies to you. This third type of programming is if you still have the old remote. And we're going to do some learning. So let me go get an old remote. Okay, folks. So here is the third way of doing this. So remember, this you actually have to have the original remote. So you go to your manual right here, and what you have to do is press and hold the TV and mute buttons at the same time, which is this TV and mute at the same time. And the red LED is going to blink twice. So now you have to press and release the key that you want to program. So let's say we want to program the power button. So you press and release that. And then the next step is to press and release the corresponding button on the original remote. So you would put them like that and press this, the corresponding key, and then you're going to get an acknowledgement. The LED is going to blink twice to tell you that there's been a correct learning, and then you're going to repeat that step again. For example, if you want to set up the volume up, you press it, and then you press volume up over here and make sure that they're aiming like that. And then when you're done with that, at the end, you're going to do this right here. When you learn all the functions you require, press and hold the power button, the power key, until the green LED blinks 4 times. So that's basically it. So let's try it. I'm going to program the power button on this. Okay, so step one, press and hold those two buttons right here. Okay, it blinks red twice. So now I want to program this, so I press it. And then I go over here and press. And then I get that acknowledgement. And then at the end, since I'm already finished, I press and hold this. And it blinks 4 times to let you know that it's ready. So now let's say I want to do channel. Let's see. Let's do volume up and volume down. So press and hold these two buttons. You get an acknowledgement. So let's do volume up. And let's do volume up over here. And you get that acknowledgement. And now let's do volume down. And now let's do volume down over here. And you get that acknowledgement. And now press and hold over here. And you're going to see it blink 4 times. And it's ready. Okay, so here we are in front of the TV. And we're going to try to program this TV with this remote using those instructions that we've covered. So the first thing we want to do is press and hold these two buttons over here. And then we push the button, press and hold the button that corresponds to your TV brand. So for me, it's gonna be this one right here. There we go. So you release and you get those two green blinking lights, and that tells you that the TV is ready. Here's TV. Here's TV continued. Stream box.
And last but not least, soundbar and audio receiver. Okay, so let's look at the simple set brand buttons, and you may pause. You can pause if you need to. And this is for TV. So now let's go to Streambox. Now let's do soundbar.